if the town invested a lot of money in this facility, lights could be added at some point in the future.
Lights could be added to any facility in the future.
Yes, I understand. Okay. Thank you for clarifying that. So I heard the mayor say the purpose of this meeting was to get the input from the public. And I would say that the athletic organizations have done a fantastic job of turning out their base. And you've heard many, many people talk about how this would be great from their perspective. I didn't hear too many people in describing where they're from describe addresses that were anywhere near the facilities. So I live quite near the facilities. There are a large number of residents who live quite near the facilities. And let me say that I don't believe the people who live near the facilities had any notice of this meeting. Okay, I only found out about it this afternoon through email, and I assure you that there would be many, many more people from the neighborhood who would like to speak had they been properly informed.
Just to interrupt you for a second, I just want to verify. Maureen, did we send out proper notification on this meeting? So how?
It was published on our website. Okay. It was sent to the Asbury Park Press, and they published the notice on that.
Tom, well, I can certainly appreciate that
everyone. Several
residents regarding, especially. Thank you, Maureen. So I can certainly appreciate that not everyone pays attention to the meetings on a regular basis, but certainly you don't expect us to call each and every person.
Absolutely.
So they have the right. We're not hiding anything. If anything, we have worked very, very hard as a committee. As a matter of fact, as I stationed tonight is an informational night. Come out, tell me what you don't like about it. Tell me what you like about it. You want five fields? You want lights? You don't want lights? You want, you know, a pinwheel, a cartwheel? What do you want? I mean, this is about information, and I can't think of any other way to do it than, and I think all of us agree that this is about hearing the public give us feedback. Now, if people don't come when we're properly noticed, I can't do anything.
So I have no doubt that you met the legal requirements for notice.
Yes, we did.
I suspect that the...
We did better than the legal. Just so you understand the legal, you only need 48 hours. We did this...
What, 2 weeks ago?
2 weeks ago. So I'm not looking at
the
memo.
It wasn't printed.
Easy.
Easy? It wasn't printed.
No, nothing from the outside.
Okay, I heard someone say it wasn't printed.
It was printed. So, it was printed on Friday, and we have the...
On Friday.
No comments from the outside. If you have something, please come to the mic. Thank you. Donna, you want to add something?
No.
Okay. Go ahead, Tom.
So I will make the point that I believe the community that's in favor of this plan was more completely notified than the community that would be directly impacted by the plan through a variety of means. And that may or may not, you may or may not agree with me on that,
okay.
But I would say that I do not believe that the public who are present here tonight are really representative of the whole community. I believe they're representative largely of a portion of the community which feels very strongly. That's just my position.
Okay.
From the point of view of a member of the community, I have to say I don't know enough about this plan. I have a lot of concern. I have concerns about potential runoff from the fields, which will contain pollutants associated with the materials that are going to go into these AstroTurf or turf-like fields, running into the groundwater and running into the reservoir. I have concerns about eventual lights, which are sure to follow, in my opinion. I have concerns about traffic. I have concerns about large number of outsiders using a facility which is going to be paid for by the Homdel tax. By the way, I heard mentioned that you're going to get a grant of about $150,000, or you're applying for a grant of about $150,000 for this entire plan. What is the total price tag estimated right now for the whole plan?
The grant is only for the top.
I understand that. So is there an estimated price for the whole thing?
It's a couple million dollars.
I'm sorry?
It's a couple million dollars. I mean, I don't have an exact, but I mean, I know what turf fields cost.
So no one's even worked up a real estimate for what this is going to cost, Mr. Broberg?
There is no real estimate for what it's going to cost. It's in that range of $2-2.5 million is probably what the cost is going to be. A lot of time and effort has not been put into that until we have public input tonight. Make whatever adjustments are necessary, then I will provide an estimate to the governing body.
Okay, thank you. And is it the governing body's intent to pay for this out of current revenue, or do you intend to borrow for it?
I don't think we've got that kind of money laying around, so most likely, if it's decided that we move forward with a project like this, we would have to borrow for it.
Okay. And I'll just remind the committee that it was maybe a few years ago when the township felt it had to sell large portions of Cross Farms just to make ends meet. And now, we're thinking about borrowing a minimum of $2 or $3 million for these improvements and passing those costs on to our future residents. So, I feel that there are a lot of questions that need to be addressed from a perspective of the township and from a perspective of the impacted community.
The good news is, Tom, there's going to be more meetings.
And I think you'll see more of us. Thank you.
Thank you. And I would like to thank our CFO at that moment. You know, I think you brought up a very good point. Our financial situation has improved greatly, and I want to thank you. Tom brought up a great point. A couple of years ago, we were struggling, and I think you've done an unbelievable job in changing that. I also want to point out that we're at 100-year lows in interest rates, and sometimes borrowing in order to invest in your future is not a bad thing. So, Deb.
Hello, Debbie Brew, 15 Cindy Lane. I just want to make a comment about his comment as far as being alerted about the meetings. This is my pet peeve in town with these meetings and Board of Ed, is that if you're interested in what's going on, you want to know what's happening, the new website is fantastic to sign up for the alerts. I get about 50 alerts a day, what the traffic is going to be or what's going on at this meeting. So I encourage everybody to go on the website, sign up for the alerts, and you'll find out everything as soon as it goes on the website. I also have a lot of friends that do live in that neighborhood and the surrounding neighborhoods. And I know a lot of them are thrilled that this is going to happen. Now, I don't know if they're here tonight or not, but they will be coming out. I know that they feel that there's some people in the town that aren't happy about it, but I have several friends that are happy these will be going in. I don't have children who play soccer or lacrosse. I have children who play football, softball, and baseball. I'm thrilled that they will be able to utilize these baseball and softball fields more at that end now, and it'll be convenient. And I'm thrilled for all my friends who do play soccer and lacrosse that they're not going to have to be at village school or cramming for fields somewhere else, and that we're finally making change at Cross Farm Park for the better of our community. We have to make progress and make it better. It can't just always stay the same.
Thank you.
My name is Sheldon Grimaldi, I've been in Homdel since 2014. I heard the Rutgers student, the soccer player, mention lights about the field.
Could you speak closer to the
Yes. Is it possible to include in this proposal lights? Because I think it would be critical for the usage of the field.
Yes. Right.
Look, I think the purpose of an informational meeting is to hear all the things that the public might or might not want. And obviously, I think a large part of the township committee is involved in the user groups. However, to be respectful to everyone in this town, you know, we're slightly concerned as a group. We instructed Ed at this time to, we didn't instruct what our plans were as an RFP to do it without the lights. One, it is expensive, and two, we're trying to minimize the conflict that it would cause between the community. Look, sports should bring people together. Doing a project like this should only enhance our community, and we want to bring people together, not divide.
No, I agree with you, and I think if you look at what we're doing with Bell Works and the type of people that we're bringing into the community, I think it's important to have upgraded facilities that's going to encourage these younger families to move to the town. Rather than looking at all the negatives, you should be looking at the positives and the increased property value that we're going to get from things like this that attract not just the people to come work here and then go live in towns around here that have the better facilities, but to actually set up shop and live in this town, not just come here, work, and go elsewhere.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. Frank Brusco, 7 Boxwood Terrace in Homdel. You know, I'm listening to everybody, what they're saying, and I honestly think we're all spoiled to think that, you know, we live in Homdel, these beautiful homes, and what we have here. We're paying so much money in taxes, everybody in this town. We have a horrible facility. I am embarrassed of the Cross Farm facility. We have a couple soccer fields. The facility looks beautiful. It's great grass, but it's of no use for any of the kids. I have 2 kids. They do play sports. Some are in dance. You know, they play soccer, dance. They do a million other things. But what are our options? Have these kids stay in the corner? We have an epidemic of, you know, heroin right now going on in this town, this Monmouth County. That's your other choice. Either we're complaining and saying to ourselves, you know, maybe we shouldn't put a light here, a light there. You know, my parents grew up on a railroad track. You know, we should be fortunate that we still have a home and a roof on top of our heads. And to have a couple of lights, just to know that our kids are safe, not in the street, not in the schoolyard, not down, you know, in an alley somewhere doing every drug in the world. Do we see the news? That every day, a kid, 2, 3, 4 kids are dying of heroin. This is the least, that's the last thing we should worry about. I think this is what we need to definitely concentrate on. You know, my little development where I live, we pay $3 million a year in taxes, if not $4 million. I think there's enough money that we could raise. I think this town needs it, wants it. Bell Works is growing. I think it's a great thing. It's a great, 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 great thing for this community and all the surrounding towns as well. I think everybody's going to benefit from this. So again, great work. I'm proud of you guys, and I'm definitely supporting it and everybody else that I deal with. So thank you again. Thank you.
I'm Jerry Chiricolo. I'm 6 Red Coach Lane, and I heard a lot of people have lived in Homdel for a long time, and I thought it'd be an interesting perspective to somebody who will be now a Homdel resident for 1 year, August 15th. We came to Homdel not just for the education, but the people, just like many of you in this room. We've met many residents from Homdel who have accepted us very welcomingly. My family and I have been very fortunate to meet a lot of you in this room who have been great friends to us and my children. And I think the important thing is reinvesting in this community and keeping it great. And I understand people's concerns about money, about other traffic, noise, other adverse things that this could bring. But to me, when I stand back and look at it as a new resident, it's a no-brainer. We are investing in our town, we're investing in our kids, we're investing in each other, and no money in the world is worth, it should be worth it. It's invaluable, I guess is the best way to say. So thank you very much, and I am in full support of this.
Thank you.
Children ages 8 and down. They all play soccer and lacrosse, and I'm now co-commissioner of lacrosse, and I can say that our facilities at Village are subpar. These fields would be a phenomenal improvement for the program in general, and I think if we don't do lights, and I would urge that we add lights to the proposal, that we're going, you know, 85% there without getting the whole project done. So I just would ask that we consider including, excuse me, lights in the project. That's it. Thank you.
All right, Kevin Gilfillan, 8 High Point Road. Without sounding redundant here, I think we're kind of getting off track. Obviously, people with the kids, with the sports, it's going to be for, you're going to have people against. I think what we really need to do is focus on how tastefully this has been done and how it's been thought out. I mean, obviously, we need more space. If anybody's been up there on a Saturday or Sunday, the place is bursting at the seams. So what are we doing? We're looking now to grow an area that's always been zoned for recreational use. We're not going to another part of town. We're not going to a different area. We're not going to protected areas. We're going to an area that's always been used or has been intended to be used as recreational use. The adding of trees, lining it. We're trying to be respectful to people that are around this area. I get the fact that you're not going to appease everybody. And if you did buy in this area and you're around this area, knowing that this was zoned for recreational use, I think the only thing you could do is see that everybody is trying to do this the right way. So once again, you're going to have people for and against. I just think that we really need to focus on how well this is thought out. Thanks.
Anybody else? Scott Goldstein, 24 East Lawn Drive.
Ed, I think there's a concern about the AstroTurf or the turf fields, and about the fact that material that's used from that comes from ground tires, and they might be a source of lead as well as other heavy metals that will be seeping into our Category 1 Willowbrook stream, which, by the way, feeds our water systems county as well as a quarter million people. I personally don't need any more lead in my water. So my concern is there's no way, and that's been a concern with a lot of AstroTurfs, and they've been taken out of some places because of those concerns.
Over the past 25 years, there have been more than 60 studies done on AstroTurf, the various types of AstroTurf throughout the country, and none of them have indicated any health hazard. And that information is available. 60 studies, some by universities, some by other public health agencies. So the question is a legitimate question. It's a concern. It's been raised before, but it's been addressed many times over.
So how do we protect if we go the route of these turf fields, these artificial turf fields, to make sure that we're not getting contaminants that will be seeping into our water system?
The materials that are used on these fields are manufactured and actually come in bags. So this is not some random acquisition of these materials. The materials that are in these fields are about 60% rubber based and about 40% sand. And they come in bags. The sand also comes in bags. So this material is carefully monitored.
Okay, so they're not using any recycled material for this?
I don't know what the source of the material in the bags are, but I do know that many, many, many studies, I know of 60 anyway, that have been done and that material is safe.
The other observation is it wasn't all that long ago that we built a turf field here in town in conjunction with the Board of Education, and mainly to address this need of fields early in the season. I can appreciate that they're wet and you can't play on them, as well as lighted fields. And we do have those facilities here in town. I personally would be much more comfortable if this proposal was done with regular grass, so we didn't have the water problem, because that's a problem that stays with us forever. And the issue with the lights, Eric, you've really put, you're sensitive to that issue. When these fields were built out originally, I think it was $6 million to the town, and then another $3 or $4 million after that. And I know the local residents in the area were adamant against any lights going up for play because of the night pollution. So that's a well-known factor here in the town. The other factor that I'd like to just point out is that I recently looked at the statistics for the town for demographics, and the majority of our town is actually over 55 years of age. So I don't know, people coming to Bellworks, you know, with the age-restricted housing that's proposed there, how many of them looking to play lacrosse or soccer at the age of 35, and we're not addressing facilities for the older community, which we pay the taxes here, okay? My concern also is the fact that we're taking on debt. You make a good point that interest rates are low now. What I would like to see the town do if they want to go down this path is to put that money aside and not to have to borrow it for a number of years as an investment, showing the discipline we can actually save money and wait until we have enough money to be able to pay for most of this without actually having to go into the markets to borrow that money.
Thank you.
Great.
Would you like to make a comment, Ed?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I'd like to address one of this gentleman's comments and a prior comment. The prior comment about screening, and I know that you've heard me say this before, Central Park, when it was built, looked not that different from what Crossbarn looked like before it was built. It was barren. Homdel Park in the mid-50s was a farm field, very similar to Crossbarn Park. we intend to put a tremendous amount of additional vegetation in this park so that it's going to resemble those areas. To a large extent, those of you, I'm sure many are familiar with Central Park. Central Park has an active and a passive theme, and so does this park. This park has walkways, shade trees, and we're going to continue to do that. It's really remarkable if you walk through Homdel Park, the size of the trees were only planted 50 years ago. I know that sounds like a long time, but you have to start somewhere. We've started in this lower part of the park more recently. So this is going to be, from both internally and externally, the vegetation that's here is going to more resemble what is like Homdel Park and Central Park. And I mean that. The type of trees, the size of the trees, I think, are really going to make a difference as we grow into the future. And by the way, for the last comment, there's an area set aside in the park for senior type of activities when and if they become necessary.
And it just made me think of a question. I know we have open space in this town. Do we separate it? Like, how much is recreation versus passive? Would you have any idea?
We have, I'm not counting the Board of Ed property, and I'm not counting the detention basins and those little open spaces. There are 1,800 acres, more or less, of open space in town that fall into three categories. The first category is passive recreation. Examples of that would be the Bayonet Farm, the northern part of the Bayonet Farm. There are open space, now I'm talking about all publicly purchased restricted lands for up. So we have passive recreation, part of which is Cross Farm Park, a substantial part of which is the county park system. I'm sure many of you have been across the street from Cross Farm Park, so that's a big passive area. Homdel Park is probably 95% passive, 5% active. Tennis courts, the Tot-lot. So of the 1,800 acres in town, approximately 1,100 are passive recreation. Walk, talk, relax, have a picnic. Of the remaining area, which is about 700 acres, part of that is farmland that will not be used by the public, but it's restricted forever. So in North Homdel, near where I live, there's the Palmer Farm, which is approximately 100 acres, restricted forever. In Central Homdel is the Plummer Farm down the street, coincidentally, approximately 100 acres, restricted forever, open space. And down here are two parcels that were acquired by the state and the county and Homdel, and in part sold off. That was the original chase tract on Homdel Road. It was almost 500 acres. Approximately half of that is open space, and you can walk through there, although it's a very long walk, very attractive walk. And 200 of those acres are set aside as 200 acre farmland parcels that are restricted. Of the 1,800 acres, approximately 150 is active recreation, most of which is right here. The other parts, just to remind you, are the Ackerson Park, the Phillips Park, the Newstead Park, those relatively small areas that are Phillips Park are just a few acres apiece. So 1,800 acres, 1,100 passive, 550 farm, 150 active.
Thank you. Questions from the less than 10%. Questions from the public? Seen?
Nope.
Bob's?
Good evening, guys, ladies and gentlemen, our township committee, mayor, township clerk. My name is Steve Cittadino. I live in 19 Mill Lane, North Homdel, way on the other side of town, and I love it. I've lived in this town for 60 years, okay? I've seen this town grow from maybe two developments to so many and the biggest homes you ever saw. And I've been involved with recreation way back in the 60s, okay, when my four children went to the schools. In fact, we didn't have school. My Linda graduated from Red Bank because we didn't have a high school. And we just had a little bit of recreation then. And I was always into recreation, like I said, four children, and then my three grandchildren come to live with me in 1994. They've been to the school system, into the recreation, whether it be the high school, HYAA, Pop Warner, okay? My thing is that I think this is a good idea. I've been involved in a lot of committees and a lot of organizations for recreation in town, and plus the town too, Bannon Farm, I've been on that a long time too. And what I see up there, I think that should be the last part of Cross Farm Park, because there's not much space left up there. I remember there was only two baseball fields, and now you've got a lot of fields up there. And looking at this diagram up there, that is a good area right there. Let's add it away, okay? Going back, I was on one committee, it was the future use of Cross Farm Park, okay? It was an organized committee that we was appointed by the township committee to see what we could do with Cross Farm, okay? We worked on it all year long, and when we got near the end of the year, we had two lighted football and soccer fields, lighted, big lights, okay? We had problems with the neighbors around the Ladwood development and that road there with those homes down there. We had meetings, lots of meetings, and we brought the people there to look and see that these lights that were gonna shine on the football and the soccer field were shining directly down. Because at that time, they had new lighting. They don't glare over houses into the next development. They shine directly down. That's the concern was from the Monmouth County Recreation, because I used to go to the Monmouth County Recreation meetings still, and they had vendors there about lights there. That's why I found out all about lights, okay? Now, that's a long time ago. Now that they make lights, you don't even know they got lights there. And these are only street lights, what we're talking about, you know, road lights. So I'm giving my support for this. You guys know me. I come right out with it, and I'm paying a lot of taxes in this town. I can't see paying for school taxes. Well, my kid, my grandchildren, and my kids went to school. I'm 84 years old. I'm still paying taxes. Okay, but what are you going to do? This is life. Without the seniors in town, you wouldn't have no schools.
You're right, Bob.
Okay, but getting back to recreation, like I said, I live in North Homdel, Palmer Avenue. I got Hazard next door to me. Middletown across the street, and I got Haysburg there. I love it there, okay? My quality of life, I love that. Roll all day long. There's not gonna be no more traffic than what is here now, okay? You're gonna give these young people in town, we need these young people in town to get into recreation, because if they don't get into recreation, they're gonna get something else, okay? My belief in this, recreation and school, we have beautiful schools here, academic, okay? Without recreation and sports, you won't have that much academic, because it goes hand in hand. We got coaches that coach games. I coach myself. I coach 20-some years of family coaching. And with the discipline we give to the kids and learn how to react with other children goes in hand in hand. So what I'm getting at, I don't want to talk too long because I like to talk. I'm giving my support for this year, even though I know it's going to cost bucks. Okay, I know about bucks. I know about what the high school field, what that costs. Okay, I was a little mad about that. Okay, but we got to keep going, okay? Right. But I'm just here to give my support to you guys and the people in the audience. I mean, a little bit of recreation, you're crowded in one place, okay? So, Cross Farm Park is still not full yet, but it's getting there. And I think this should be the last leg up there, really.
Thanks for all you do for the town, Bob.
Thank you. Thank you.
I no longer have any children who will benefit from this at all, so when I say in support of this project, I say only from the heart. I think that while I listen to everyone's comments, I work in the real estate field. Most people who know I'm an attorney. I speak to buyers and sellers all day and night long. No, people probably won't move here because we have added two turf fields to Cross Farm. But when they look around, they look at our township as a whole, and they look at our facilities, and they compare us to nearby towns like Marlborough and Allegan. They have much nicer recreational facilities than we do. And that goes into the decision that people make when they decide where they're going to live. So when we don't upgrade our facilities, when we don't add things here, we're hurting the value of all of our homes and our real estate. And that's very short-sighted. Yes, money is tight. Nobody wants to spend money. Certainly, nobody wants to pay more in taxes. But we're all hurting our investments by not considering upgrades to our infrastructure. Now, as far as the lights are concerned, for 15 years, I think, or thereabouts, we've had portable lights at Crosswalk Park. They are diesel-powered, they are loud, they are difficult, and they're, in today's age, probably not very light efficient. They don't light the area well. They make a lot more light for the surrounding population. I think it's very short-sighted not to put lights in this project. My own personal opinion is it was unfortunate that when the project was approved, when Cross Farm was first approved, that lights weren't put in then. I understand that was a compromise for the few people who live around Cross Farm who would be negatively impacted. The fact remains, it really doesn't allow for adequate use of the park when it's dusk. In October, it's dark at 5 o'clock. That means without lights, our children have nowhere to go. And to the points here, when the kids aren't involved in sports, they're involved in things that we don't want them to be involved in. We don't have a town center, we don't have a community center, we don't have a place for kids to go. This is it. Our sports are the center of this town. And lights will give our youth the ability to practice into the evening. The township committee can control the safeguards for that, what time they go off, what days they're used. My understanding, and Ed, I would allow you to comment, is that today's lighting is very energy efficient. It can be very controlled so that it would have minimal disruption to the neighboring homes. But I'm going to strongly urge this committee to consider the implementation of lights in this proposal.
Thank you. Anybody else has comments you want to get in line? We'll come to the end of the night. Thank you.
Mike Bachman, 36 Ladwood Drive. To the comment before, who lives close to this? I'm probably right on the northern end of that picture. I appreciated Jay's fervor when the Capelli complex was going up, and the mayor, you came out and you met with everybody at the church around the corner, and you listened to everybody in the council as well. And that
was a great night.
It was very appreciative, and that project was, I think, appropriately killed. But I think part of what we argued for at the time, at least a lot of us in that group, was we didn't want to have bookended facilities that just take up Newman Springs Road, and we have, you know, so much traffic, there's nothing we can do. But as to the point someone else made, I've been here 4 years. I have a 6-year-old, a 10-year-old, and an 11-year-old. None of them play soccer, none of them play lacrosse, but this is what we wanted done. So don't get a new facility down the road. Make this facility better and make it work better for what we need in the town. And I appreciate your respect of the time of usage and lights. There's some more detail on that if that ever becomes part of this proposal. I think that's what the people in the neighborhood are really concerned about. So, but I think I speak for a lot of our neighbors that we're generally in support of doing something better with Cross Farm. Just don't build another facility. Thanks.
Thank you.
I've lived in the town for over 15 years, very involved in the soccer community, as well as other sports in town. And I think the Cross Farms facility is a great facility. You can drive by there on any fall or spring night or day, evening, or the weekend, and you'll see hundreds of kids out there. And as a father of three kids, I think anything that keeps our kids, you know, off the couch, away from the electronics and out of trouble is a great thing. So I'm totally in favor of this or anything that improves this area, because it's not just a sports complex. It's an area where we gather as a community. You know, we don't have a real space or a gathering space where we can gather as a community. And it's just nice seeing other families up there, being able to commune with other families in Homdel. It's more than just a sport. sports complex. And these are more than just fields. It's places where we all gather, where we talk to each other, where we're friends, you know, where we can get together as friends. So I think this is a great idea. I think it's an investment, not only now, but in the future for Homdel. So.
Thank you.
Chris Flynn, 1 Carroll Court. I've been in Homdel for 20 years now. I coach the 5th and 6th grade lacrosse team, who was 14-2 this year, thanks to Mr. Nicholas. And so I just want to highlight the popularity of lacrosse in this town. We started this program 4 years ago. My first year coaching this age group, we probably had 13, 14 kids, and this year I had 29. So I have to field 10 kids out of 29. And as a result of that, we traveled to these other towns, as been mentioned earlier, Brick, Manalapan, Jackson, all these towns that have turf fields. It's a phenomenal experience. It's a different game on a turf field. The village fields, we're thankful for them, but it takes a lot to maintain them. They don't get cut enough, and the game is different. It slows the game down tremendously. So I just want to say, with the popularity of the sport in this town, and it's only going to grow with the kids behind us and the clinics, I think the turf fields are a phenomenal idea. So I support it.
Thank
1,000%.
I just had a quick follow-up.
Go ahead.
It's not going to be a blessing. I just want to clarify, because there was a chuckle about the disclosure that was absurd, that the disclosure was proper. I just want you to know that on Monday of last week, Monday afternoon or Tuesday morning, we started getting word from the various sports groups in town that they were aggressively marketing this meeting. We called the township committee office.
I'm sorry, who's we?
We, our group. A group.
Village. Okay, I didn't know what group.
Sorry. We called, and Maureen, I think you were out, and we said, I'm sorry, is there some meeting coming up with this? And we were told yes, and notice went out to the Asbury Park and everything on the 13th. Well, it turns out that was just an informational notice that did not get published. But there's nothing on the, and Eric, I think this is good for future for you guys. I said, but there's nothing on the website, and I'm getting emails and links to the sports groups, again, all due respect, that there's a big meeting on it. And there's nothing on the website, and I was told, Maureen, you weren't in, I was told it's not going on the website because it's a special meeting, and special meetings don't go on the website. And I said, well, that's interesting, because the JCP&L one was on the website, and I was told, notice for this will go out on Thursday or so when Maureen gets back. I said, that's interesting. We put our email that afternoon, and when you know what, someone logged in that night at 8 o'clock or so and put out an email from the town, and also... Okay, great. You were on vacation. You've done a lot of things on vacation.
7 days before the meeting, it was posted.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I respect everyone's views here. We all have different views. But the notice for this meeting was not that good. And there's been other situations like this. And I think you'll have more feedback from the Ladwood area, notwithstanding Mike's comments. And I think we really need to be concerned, especially about the noise factor. The lights are new, they're technologically great, they're efficient, they shine down. But my question here is, and I'll leave, how many activities or games would that facility max out with during a tournament, for example? I mean, how many fields are there now or practice now? 10?
Depends. I mean,
I could, what the concern for me and a lot of my constituents is, a lot of this makes sense, but a lot of it doesn't, because this whole thing could turn into a circus at peak times, including 600 parking spaces.
So can we make a note to make sure we do not allow any animals, no elephants?
No.
I don't want it to be this hard.
I mean, seriously, but noted there. Thank you.
Listen, Jack, tonight's informational. Tonight was about hearing feedback. We have a recreational committee, and I think that's where... You know, the recreational committee made a recommendation, and they're excited. And yes, they come from the user group, so it's very possible that they said, "Hey, you know, we're our proposal is going to be heard." So clearly, we hear all kinds of proposals all day long. I certainly don't make it my I don't spend all day reminding people to log on, look at the website, or check the newspaper and all the notifications. I can tell you this, in this particular situation, because I was very aware of the sensitivity, we did everything we could to notify people. And look, there's going to be, we're not voting tonight on this thing happening. Tonight was informational. So the good news is, anybody wants to come, can come to the next meeting.
Oh, I agree.
And they're going to be able to say their piece. But you know what, Jay, look, some of those other questions, how many and how many not, look, certain weekends is busier than others. You know, I mean, lacrosse games have varying times, the soccer has varying times. All I can tell you is the lacrosse people have done an unbelievable job in 4 years of expanding the amount of Homdel kids playing. The leadership and the soccer program have had 51 teams. 4 years ago, probably had 20-something. So we have a growing interested participation rate. By the way, we've had tremendous success for a town, which I think is positive. Like, those are things that I think help the community. State championships get you positive press. It does. It puts the town on the map. So those are all, I think, positive things. So tonight is about learning about what, you know, structurally would make sense and what wouldn't make sense. And then we continue on with the process.
So on a crazy Saturday there, what percentage is Homdel typically? If that thing's running full bore?
Tremendously high.
Over 60?
Well over 60.
Okay, good.
Nice.
Okay, good. And the final comment is, if the disclosure on this was so good, it wouldn't have been punted till the end of the week unless we got involved. And it wouldn't simply say, including as of this afternoon, we're going to discuss recreation and parks improvement. These are full-blown plans at phase one, if you will. And again, I look forward to hearing from Mr. Perdue about his comments.
Thank you. I'm sure he listens. Looks forward to it.
There.
Okay. I think that's it. Any other? Oh, we have Carol. That's it. I gave Jenny two, but I don't want to do any doubles because then everybody else got to come up with a double. So let's. Anybody new? I got one new. This is the last one of the night.
Mayor, if I could just interject real quick, there seems to be some confusion on noticing a meeting.
Yeah.
So Maureen, can you just go over real quickly what the town's required to do and what we did do?
Well. The notification is required 48 hours before the meeting.
Only 48 hours. We noticed this more than a week ahead of time, correct? Okay.
Yes. It was published in the, I have to say, it was published in the Asbury Park Press on Friday, which is more than 48 hours, but it was towards the end of the week. And because, if I publish it too early, people say it was too early, they forget about it, too late, they didn't have enough notice. It's difficult. But so we keep with the requirements. But it was on the website a week before the meeting.
So going forward, all our meetings are posted on the website.
They are.
So those residents who want to know about a meeting simply have to sign up for notification on the website. Mm-hmm. And once the agenda is posted, they will be notified. Is that correct?
The agenda is usually published. It's sent to the committee on Friday. And if there are no concerns or comments, it's posted on Monday.
I got to tell you, I think our one resident just pointed that out so beautifully.
Yes, and I just wanted to
iterate. It's not hard to sign up.
Exactly.
Is it, Donna?
Not at all. So I want everyone to understand.